Prime Minister Anthony Albanese will meet with French President Emmanuel Macron this week in an attempt to fix the two countries' damaged relationship. Live to Federal Politics reporter Eliza Edwards. Eliza, the PM took a sly dig at Scott Morrison before his trip.
Yeah, Carl, he couldn't resist that. The PM was talking about a trip to Paris next week while he's in Europe meeting world leaders. Anthony Albanese will be trying to patch things up with the French after the relationship turned sour last year because of that dumped submarine deal. President Emmanuel Macron responded badly by accusing Scott Morrison of telling him lies and leaking their texts. Anthony Albanese says it's clear he needs to hit the reset button, taking a swipe at the former PM.
I'll meet with President Macron, who I've had really constructive discussions with, who doesn't have to worry about any leaking of text messages.
The PM was keeping his cards close to his chest about whether he'll take up an invitation to visit Ukraine next week as well. It is a conflict zone, so details are likely to be tightly held. Carl?
Eliza, thank you.
Well, the Prime Minister flies to Europe this weekend, where he'll meet on the sidelines of the NATO summit with the French President after that relationship soured over the failed submarine deal. To discuss, we're joined by Deputy Prime Minister Richard Marles, who's joining us in Rwanda, and Opposition Leader Peter Dutton in Canberra. Nice to see you both this morning. So, Richard,
how are you guys?
You're in Africa. I know Albo's jetting off to Europe and Penny Wong to Asia. Does your government not like being at home?
We love being at home, but there is work to be done overseas, and certainly there's work to be done with fixing the relationship with France, with so many things that we've seen over the last month where the Liberals have stuffed it. We're busily fixing it, and that goes to our relationship with France, which is a critically important relationship for the country, and it's going to be really important that Anthony's going to have the opportunity of meeting with President Macron to put a relationship with a country who's actually one of our nearest neighbours. They're a Pacific country, as in terms of their Pacific territories, to get that back on track. And he's looking forward to the opportunity to do that.
Peter, what do you reckon about that? Albo off to break a baguette with the French president, of course, because you broke the relationship, didn't you?
Well, we took a decision that was in our country's best interests. Alan, we won't apologise for that. The AUKUS deal with the United States and the United Kingdom meant that we got a security underpinning for our country for the next 4 or 5 decades, and it meant a tough decision in terms of terminating the contract with the French. They took offence to that, understandably. It was a big contract, but in the end, we acted in our country's best interests, and that's what you would expect us to do, and I certainly expect Richard to do the same in relation to any decisions he's got to make. I'm employed by the Australian people, and my job is to keep our country safe and to make sure that we make the right decisions that are going to protect us into the future.
There are big crowds and long queues at airport terminals across the country this morning as millions of Aussie families prepare to jet off for the school holidays.
Yeah, for more, let's bring in Australian Traveller Magazine's Quentin Long. He is in Perth. Quentin, the holiday exodus has already begun. I mean, you were saying the other day there's really no way of avoiding this now, is there?
Yeah, morning DC, morning Sylvia. Unfortunately, we're just going to have to grin and bear it. It is really difficult to solve the problem of staffing that has been plaguing every industry across Australia, and the airlines and the, you know, airports are no different. So until they get those staffing, you know, problems solved, we'll have to endure this over most holidays. The good news is, I don't know whether you guys saw it, but our correspondents in the airports at Melbourne and Brisbane were showing that the queues have subsided, so it looks a bit clearer than it was earlier this morning.
It's just the beginning, though, of the holiday rush, Quentin. So what is your advice for travellers right now if they are preparing to fly?
Yeah, Sylvia. So, look, the first and most important thing is if you are flying, check in online. You can check in on Virgin up to 48 hours before you fly on a domestic flight and 24 hours for a Qantas flight. So check in online. That means all you have to do when you get to the airport is print out bag tags and drop them off. And it depends on the airline that you're flying with. You can usually drop off your bags up to 3 hours before your departure. So that means, DC, when we spoke during the week, you said, can you really get there more than 2 hours beforehand? Absolutely, particularly if you have checked in online. The other thing is, if you can, don't take, you know, don't check in luggage, see if you can only take carry-on, but not everyone can avoid that. The other thing, and I said it on Tuesday or Wednesday when I spoke to you, just pack some patience, be nice to the staff. The staff are doing their best, and they're the ones that actually did turn up, and they know it's going to be a tough day.
They are. We're going to talk about the staff again in a minute, but I just want to stay on this for a little bit longer. If we want to do a last-minute getaway, Q-Dog, what are the best regions?
Yeah, so it's really, really interesting market at the moment, DC. In the 10 years that I've been speaking to you, it's really odd. For example, the cities, because there's no business travel and there is actually, you know, no international travel, the cities are really empty and crying out for people. And then if you want to go into regions, look at places like Port Stephens, Clarence Valley and Yamba in New South Wales, Gippsland in Victoria, the Gold Coast and the Sunshine Coast hinterland, and then finally over here, Perth, as I said, the cities, but also just a bit further south, Bunbury in WA have got availability as well.
Where are the best deals for us then, Quentin?
Yeah, so I've found some interesting deals. Starting off in Sydney, I was talking about those cities. The Park Hyatt is probably the most exclusive five-star hotel in Australia, and I've never seen this before. They've got a stay three, pay two deal on at the moment, and that's valid through the school holidays.
Wow.
If you ever wanted to have a really indulgent sort of family holiday, that's what I'd be looking for. And again, following that trend in Victoria, the Intercontinental Rialto, $332 a night during the school holidays for a family of four.
Wow.
In Queensland, you can go to the Gold Coast. There's some great availability there as well. The Mantra Legends, that's a famous, you know, sort of four-star hotel in Surfers. They've got it for about $176 a night. And over here at Scarborough Beach at the Radisson Vertra Blue, they've got a deal on as well during the school holidays. It's really unusual. It's great value in those sort of destinations if you can find it.
Looks good. Hey, before we let you go, Quentin, Christina Hearn just broke the news that Qantas is offering a one-off payment of $5,000 to Qantas staff. This excludes anyone in the upper levels of management at the company. What do you make of the timing of this announcement?
Yeah, so, look, it shows you the desperation that everybody in the industry has to maintain their staff or keep their staff because it is such a difficult market. And they know that in such a tight market like this, everybody can move jobs and step up their salary. So they're trying to retain staff. The timing is particularly interesting. In other words, they know they're in for some bad press about the queues, but hopefully that won't happen. And I think that's one way of sort of offsetting some bad news that they may be getting. But at the end of the day, it's great for the staff of Qantas. It shows you their intention to really make sure staff are looked after and retain those staff. Interestingly, the guys at Flight Centre did a very similar thing about 2 weeks ago where they distributed millions of dollars of value in shares to staff to retain them. So, look, these are some of the you know, innovative ways that the industry is trying to hold on to staff and make sure they can start to deliver the services.
All right, love your work. Quentin Long, thank you. Have safe travel. Over the next few days. See you soon.